We go to Central America now, where the Honduran government has illegally dismissed 8,000 public employees under pressure from the International Monetary Fund. The move comes in direct violation of the country's labor laws, leaving many with hope that they will, in fact, get their jobs back. Here's Gerardo Torres.
This month, 8,000 public employees of several state companies in Honduras have been fired without warning, a move which goes against the country's labor laws.
No llegó a cabo ese proceso. Eso implica.
The state didn't follow the correct process. This means that the state will have to pay damages in addition to 4 months' salary. Each worker should also be paid another 30 days of salary as compensation.
Le tiene que pagar una indemnización de 30 días de salarios a cada uno.
This could mean around $5,000 each, meaning a total of around $16 million that the state will have to pay.
Jurídicamente, de conformidad a la ley, está para ganar.
We are working within the law, and in this case we can't lose. But we have a government that has ignored its institutions, where there is no separation of powers, and a state in which every office responds to the interests of President Juan Orlando Hernández.
Donde la institucionalidad casi toda o toda está sometida a las directrices del presidente Juan Orlando Hernández.
Other union leaders believe that the agreement with the International Monetary Fund is so strong that the government is willing to continue with the privatization of an important portion of public property.
We are seeing that there are around 140,000 workers in the public sector, but only 100,000 will remain. That means 40,000 dismissals will take place in the next 3 years, and they have already begun.
The International Monetary Fund and the Honduran government have become a much more profound stage of neoliberalism. Yet organized workers are fighting for their rights and are pushing to stop the accelerated privatization. However, they also need the participation of other social movements. Gerardo Torres, Telesur, Central America.